Hello, this is Carson Cook, your CSO Pro, and welcome to the channel. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button and turn on the notification bell so that you won't miss any of our future uploads. Enjoy the video. Hello again, good morning or good afternoon, wherever you are. Again, we're back with the CSO Pro, and my name is Carson Cook, and today we're gonna be talking about pretty simple topic. We actually have some videos on this topic. If you click the link below, we have a few other videos on objections and on how to handle objections, but we've been getting a lot of a lot of younger sales professionals kind of, you know, asking about objections. So today we're going to talk about the basic topic of objections. Okay, so objections, what are they? What are the different thought processes or school of thinking around how to handle objections or meeting concerns? This is a fun topic to talk about because obviously we need to define this, guys. Talk about what are objections with clients. What is that? First off, if you're new to sales, getting into sales, what's an objection? What's a concern? What's an issue, right? So what we're gonna talk about today, guys, the first one is gonna be what are objections? Kind of an idea of what an objection is. Second thing is on how overcoming objections, or the idea of overcoming objections, or the idea of actually resolving concerns, and the different thought processes of the kind of the history of objections, the history of sales, history of client dealing with clients, and kind of the thought processes of, you know, meeting objections or overcoming objections, or what you normally be taught. And then also we're going to talk about the third point about objections is the idea or the mindset of actually wanting objections. Like, you want objections from your client, you want concerns, you want issues. And you know, a lot of people say, well, Carson, why would we want concerns? Why would we want objections? Well, you need concerns, guys. You need concerns that bring up positive conversations, right? That bring up positive, things around your product. And we'll talk about that. So first off, guys, what is an objection? If you're new to sales, you know, you get this manual that says, well, here's the objections. You need to learn how to overcome objections. What are objections? Guys, objections are when a client or a group or whoever's buying your product has a concern or an issue surrounding either your company, you as a salesman, the product, the price, any concern that they would have with moving forward through the process, okay? Now, I teach objections like thinking about, I would say going down a hallway, right? And at the end of the hallway is your client, and they have a gun, right? They got this gun and the gun's pointed at you. And every time they fire a bullet and it's coming right at you, it's gonna stop your process. It's gonna stop you in your tracks, right? You have to dodge the bullet, right? And that's basically, for example, in the sale, an objection. When you make your way to the client or the very end there, the person shooting at you, that's the close. That's the close of the deal, right? And each line that you cross through that hallway, that's a step of the sale. So a bullet is gonna get you to go to the left or go to the right of the steps of the sale, right? And that's what is gonna throw your game off. So it's important to learn the process, your company process, but it's important to understand each and every objection and have at least one or two or maybe even three answers to that objection. So objections are super important, okay? They're very, very important. And that's what an objection is from a client that, you know, has a concern, right? Now, we're gonna talk about the two different thought processes of, you know, we would say overcoming objections or meeting concerns with your client. And the first one is the overcoming objections, which is more of like the aggressive term where you defeat the objection, right? You work with your client and you beat them, right? Like an argument, you win the argument, okay? You beat them into submission, right? That's the old school thought process of how you meet objections. And there's a bunch of different books out there with the new thought process, guys, of actually handling and resolving real concerns from a client. And that's the different mode now, right? Let's say the old stuff doesn't work, the newer stuff works. Guys, it's all the same thing. Merchants are still, clients, merchants, people that you deal with, your board, the company, the department that you're selling the product to, they're going to have real concerns, right? And your job as a sales professional is to communicate those concerns in a way that you let them know that you understand them, okay? And the old thought process is overcoming them, like beating them into submission. Like, oh, you got that concern, don't worry about that, ignoring the objection, which is actually a technique, but kind of overly aggressively taking the concern and beating it down, right? And that's the old school thought process. And a lot of times, guys, nowadays, that really doesn't work. And a lot of products are being sold right now, whether it's houses, cars, this, that, whatever. It really takes some brain power, guys. It takes some knowledge around your product, knowledge around your company, knowledge around the concern that they might have, and knowledge of their business to actually come up with resolving, okay, that real concern.
So if you empathetically, which means that you know, you really care about this client and you really care about your product that you're selling, and you really address that concern in a very positive way, you're not really overcoming it. You're working through a solution. And we have this video, the Plan A, Plan B, and Plan C video, and that's the thought process when you need to, you know, get through your brain when you're actually trying to resolve concerns with your client, right? Or the department, or the group of people that you're selling to, or whoever, okay? Is having that idea that there is always a way around an objection. There's always a way to solve a concern. And it's what you say that will get you to close the deal. That's how you handle those objections, or how you handle or resolve the concerns with the intended group. Okay, and you need to find out a way to do that, positive, clear, and concisely, so that you're on good communication with your client. So when that concern comes up, you can find the pain points of your product, pain points of the price, pain points of the concern that they have, and project to them how they should be thinking about that concern, right? And that's how you resolve that concern. You show them a different way around. You give them a plan A, a plan B, and a plan C to that group or that client, so that it's optimal for them to move forward onto the next part of the sale. And it's always good, guys, to meet objections off the bat, to put them on the table. And it's awkward sometimes to say, well, I'm gonna address this concern. Now, most of the groups that I've worked with before in the past, or most clients like yourself that I've worked for in the past, they actually had this concern, and this concern. And I actually know this right now, that coming right into this meeting, I know you're gonna have this concern, and this concern, because they did. So let me show you how I worked our way around this concern, this concern, and this concern, and I think actually it's gonna be more beneficial for you and your company, and here's why. You meet the concern before the client even brings it up. And that's one of the best ways to deal with an objection. Now, the third thing is wanting objections. Now, I can give you a really great example of this. Why, Carson, why would I want objections? Why would I want to bring up concerns with my client? If they don't bring up the concern and I don't bring up the concern and we sell the deal, then, you know, it's time less wasted. Not necessarily. Most of the time, yeah, guys. I mean, most of the time, yeah, if it's not a real big concern, don't bring it up. You don't want to bring up negative stuff. You want to stay positive. But the biggest obvious elephant in the room concerns your client will have, you need to attack them first. You need not to attack them. You need to resolve them fast and efficiently. And you want objections. You want to have a client that has concerns. Okay, and you need to recognize when a client doesn't have concerns, they might be wasting your time. They might be screwing around with you. You're going through a whole sales process and like, yep, sure, that sounds great. Let's do it. Oh, this is great. Awesome. Oh, first, no problem. Where do I sign? They're not going to sign. Okay, they're not going to work with you. They're just playing with you. Okay, because a real client, guys, is going to have real concerns around the money and the value that they have. In any situation, even when someone donates money to a nonprofit organization, okay, they will have concerns. And that's not like it's just a red carpet sale. There's not, you know, it's no such thing as a red carpet sale. If it is a red carpet sale, it's too good to be true, and you guys really need to research your client. Slow down, put on the brakes. Now, why do we want objections? Well, just like a shortstop in professional baseball, okay, very agile professional athlete, right? And their whole job is to want ground balls, okay? Now, that they want ground balls. They want the ball hit to them every time because they're confident they're going to fill that ball, throw it to first base, and get the guy out, right? And they're professionals at it. So you can't put a shortstop there, one of the best players on the team, if they're afraid of ground balls, if they don't want ground balls. They don't want ground balls, put them in the outfield, right? It's the same kind of thing, guys, in sales professionals. You want sales professionals that want objections. You want to be able to handle concerns. And you say, why would we want to handle concerns? Guys, that is one of the best ways, honestly, the best ways to actually build rapport is to prove to your client that you can meet objections. You can show them that you understand their concerns and you can give them real solutions. The more solutions in your sales process that you can provide to that client, okay, as far as for a problem, solve, problem, solve, problem, solve, problem, solve, and you finally arrive at the close, it's gonna be very easy to close that deal. They're like, man, this guy's awesome. He's met every concern I had. I'm so confident. The trust level, I put him through all my tests as a client. Let's do it. Let's do the deal. I'll sign right here. So you want objections. It opens up the round table for discussion. Okay, real concerns, okay, give you an opportunity to communicate with your client. It gives you the opportunity to prove to them that you're a master sales professional, a master communicator, and no matter what objection you have, you're the smart person that can always come up with a plan A, a plan B, and a plan C. So what would I do? Guys, what you need to do is you need to find out what your product is and write down all the possible, physical, possible, mental, whatever objections or concerns that your client might have. Then what you need to do is you need to write down in a notebook, guys, write down at least 3 or 4 responses to each one of those objections. It might take you a while. And then you need to memorize that. And that's how you're going to be able to handle objections right off the bat. Because when you do that, you need to make sure you have an answer to every question. All right, so rock and roll, guys. This is the topic on objections. We'll talk to you soon.